Being a DJ in Malaysia is really tough. Like for me, I started out when I was 17 and I was a kid, you know? And like there weren't much turntables, there weren't much vinyls, you couldn't find anything. We didn't have internet. Well, we had dial-up internet, which was really slow. We didn't know where to look for it, you know? And like for me, when I started out, I really wanted to be a turntablist. I really wanted to scratch and be juggler and all. And for that, we need a special kind of records, like which they are called scratch records. And we had to travel from KL to Singapore to buy records and come back. And as you are 17, 18 years old, we don't even have money to stay at a hotel. So we take a train from KL in the morning, and we go and buy records and then come back by night. Yeah, and that's what we did for a long while, for about 2 years.
When I started off, I went to a school to actually learn how to DJ. A school which is called Place Universe. Me and a whole bunch of other friends, you know, like DJ Fuzz, Goldfish, T-Bone, Caesar. We actually started off learning how to DJ in a school, in an environment, in a very academic environment. And one of the very, very main objectives of that school was to change this perception that the DJ profession is something that is negative. As far as the Malaysian scene goes, I think we've kind of like met that objective and we kind of like, you know, changed that perception. So there's more to being a DJ rather than just playing club. And it's not negative, you know, you can lead a very, very positive life.
Back then, when I was actually housemates with Malik, and I used to actually produce songs using the PlayStation because I didn't have enough cash to buy a computer or an archive sampler or whatever, speakers and all that. And there was this game that was introduced to me by a friend of mine. It was called Music 2000, MTV Music Generator. And I found out that you could actually sample from CDs. Samples were all sampled on 22 kilohertz only. Because that was what the memory card could hold, you see. Malik came to me and he was like, "Hey, dude, jom kita buat satu lagu." And I was like, "Oh, okay, let's work on a song lah." And then T-Bone came over and then he was like running through his vinyl for some samples. And then we came across this Anak Ayam punya sample. And then we were like, "Hey, jom, let's try this lah." So what I did was I actually got T-Bone to copy the sample on CD. So using that CD, I extracted it into my PlayStation. Using the Music 2000, saved it on the memory card, and I just did whatever programming I could lah. There, macam ni buat lagu bro, dulu. You see, this is what I mean by bare minimal lah. Macam dulu, okay, budak-budak zaman dulu, if you want to go and jam, they will go to Central Market. Bus mini, I need to have 50 cents to take a bus mini to Central Market. If 50 cents was all I had, I would go to Central Market and I would stay there the whole night. Budak-budak zaman sekarang, lu ajak, "Hey bro, jom practice." "Hey bro, tak boleh, aku tak ada transport."
Look, I am your father.
Star Wars.